What's happening, y'all? In this video, we're gonna get our first bit of practice using MATLAB's command window. Remember, in the layout that we're gonna use in our work together, the command window sits right in the middle. On the left-hand side, we had this current folder window. The right-hand side, we had something called the workspace. We also used the layout button to make sure that we had the command history in the bottom right-hand side. We're gonna talk about each of these as our course goes on. For now, I wanna talk about how to use this command window to enter executable code. Let's take a look at our first example. Suppose that I wanna use MATLAB as a simple calculator to add 3 plus 7. In this case, I simply click right next to those double arrows. Those two symbols together are known as the command prompt. When I click next to that command prompt, you'll see a cursor, and then I type MATLAB executable code, in this case, the number 3, followed by the plus symbol, followed by 7. When I hit the enter button, MATLAB will execute that line of code and produce the value of that line. Now, this little thing here that say ANS, that's called the answer variable. If I do not store this statement as a variable, MATLAB will automatically store it in the variable answer. Let's see what I'm talking about here. Let's say that I wanted to find 2 to the 6th power. If I hit enter on that, automatically what happens is MATLAB takes the output of that command, the value of this thing, and stores it in the variable answer. Now, this is where things get fun. Not only do I have a running calculator in the command window, but MATLAB also gives me access to some useful information. Over here in the workspace, this is where I can see the variables in MATLAB that have been stored. Formally speaking, I did not assign the output of either of these two commands to a variable name, so MATLAB automatically assigned the variable ANS, and that variable right now stores the number 64. In other words, the workspace window shows me which variables are being used in this session of MATLAB. Down here in the command history window, notice that my most recent commands that I typed in the command window show up at the bottom there. So specifically, let's say that I did a new one, and in this case, I wanted to find 10 divided by 2. That command, now that I've executed it, shows up in the command history, so that if I wanted to run that command again, all I have to do is go over here, I could double click it to automatically run it, or I could simply click and drag into the command window, allowing me to access previous information that was in the command window. Now, one thing that's kind of interesting, the only place that I can input commands in the command window is right next to the command prompt. Up here, this shows me a history of what I have run in this session of MATLAB, but I cannot execute up here. When I try to take this code and run it, I can't do it because the only input for the command window is right next to that command prompt. Let's take a look at the next example of how to use the command window to execute MATLAB code. Before we do that, notice that our command window is getting a little bit messy. We've done a few commands already and it's kind of get mucked up. So let's go ahead and clear that. To do that, we're gonna type CLC, which is to clear the command window. When I execute that code, notice that all of the work that I had previously done now disappears. One call out here is just because I have cleared the command window doesn't mean that I've cleared my variables. So specifically, the last command that I executed, which was 3 plus 7, because I didn't specifically assign that to a variable, MATLAB stored it in a default variable called ANS for answer. The value of that is still 10. If I wanted to clear my workspace, if I wanted to get rid of the previously stored variables in MATLAB's memory, I could actually type the command clear. When I execute that command, that clears the workspace. After I'm done there, I could clean up my command window by typing CLC again. The next thing we're gonna do is take a look at how to capture the output of commands as user-defined variables, variables that we ourselves can define. To do that, we're gonna use the following syntax. This equal sign is gonna play many roles in our course. Right now, we're gonna call that the assignment operator. So anytime we type in equal sign to the command window, we're going to assign a variable the output value of an expression. The syntax, the way we actually type this, is to the left-hand side, on the left-hand side of the assignment operator, we're going to type some variable name. Then we're going to type the assignment operator. And then on the right-hand side, we're going to type expression, some executable command that MATLAB can calculate and then store in our chosen variable name. Let's take a look at an example of this. Suppose that we wanted to calculate the value of 64 times 32 and store the output of that calculation in a variable m. Well, to do that, we're going to use the assignment operator, which is just the equal sign. And then what we'll say is 64 times 32. When I execute that code, MATLAB takes the output of this expression, this calculation, does some internal work, and then stores that output in a variable called m. This command window log tells me, hey, the user input the command m gets 64 by 32. The output, 2048, is stored in the variable m. I see that over in my workspace, the variable m gets value 2048. Now, if I wanted to use m in a different calculation, suppose that I wanted to divide that value by 2, I can now refer to the previously stored value of m by just typing that value in the command window. Notice, because this new calculation did not have a specific variable name attached to it, MATLAB used the default variable. If, however, I wanted to capture the output of this calculation in another variable, let's call it n, so n gets m divided by 2. When I write the assignment operator, it's not the equal sign, I like to think about it as assignment operator, that tells me the value of my variable, this variable n, which I am naming, is going to be written with the output of the calculation m divided by 2. Now, when I store that, n is indeed 2048 divided by 2. Interesting thing about this is I can now overwrite that with some other value. Specifically, what I've just said is the variable n gets the value 1. Notice this is where life departs from mathematics. Here we have a statement n equals 1024. Similarly, we have a statement n equals 1. They can't both be equal, mathematically speaking, but that's not what's happening inside the computer. Inside the computer, I've told, hey, MATLAB, please store the output of m divided by 2 in this variable n. Here I'm saying, MATLAB, please store the value of 1 in the variable n. Because I execute this line of code second, MATLAB is going to overwrite that previous variable and store the value 1 in it. You can see those updates over here. If I were to execute this line of code again, notice in my workspace, once I execute, right now the value of n is 1. When I execute that code, it gets overwritten by the value 1024, which is m divided by 2. If I wanted to change that again, perhaps I say that it's 5 to the second power. When I execute that line of code, the pre-existing variable n gets overwritten with that value, with the latest execution or the latest reference to that variable. That concludes our introduction to how to use the command window to perform simple calculations and also store variable values. Before we end this video, let's go ahead and clear our workspace. So I type clear and I hit enter. Notice that all the variable values are now gone. So I've lost all that information. The other thing we'll do is we'll clean up the command window. To do that, we type CLC and clean it up. In the next video, we'll dive deeper into how to use variables in MATLAB and the features of this MATLAB desktop that allow us to leverage that type of work. I'll see you there.